let's talk about phobia or phobic disorders. Mainly, phobia is divided into two main types, specific phobia and social phobia. So what is phobia? Phobia refers to an excessive fear of a specific object or a situation. You call a person phobic or being suffering with phobic disorder when there is excessive fear, more than what one expects as a response to that particular situation. Specific phobia is a strong persisting fear of an object or situation. Especially specific phobia, the individuals, for example, they anticipate excess harm in situations like, for example, while crossing a road, they see a dog or two, and they anticipate that the dog might bite them, and or in certain situations like in an elevator. This is one of the more common types of phobia, where in an elevator, the person anticipates that the elevator may get blocked or the power may be lost, and there may be no way for him to escape from that situation. Or even in closed rooms, you might have seen people, you might have experienced, wherein it's a claustrophobia, wherein people, if you make them sit or give them, assign some work and ask them to sit in a closed room, it's not possible to them. They can't sit for long because the phobia sets in and they become panicky. A social phobia is a strong persisting fear of situations in which embarrassment can occur according to that individual. For example, speaking in public, that can be social phobia, or we also call it social anxiety disorder according to the latest DSM guidelines. This can cause various panic symptoms simply because the person anticipates that he might go wrong, he or she might go wrong in delivering their lecture or giving their speech, and that they might be embarrassed or they might be humiliated. There are cases where persons may fear using public toilet even. This we call it as shy bladder, wherein they are not able to, although they might have the urge to urinate, they may not be able to in a public toilet. So this is another type of social phobia. So some of the more common types of phobia, although there are acrophobia, that is fear of heights, agoraphobia, that is fear of open places, claustrophobia, that is fear of closed spaces, hydrophobia, fear of water, cynophobia, fear of dogs. There are some more like zoophobia, the fear of animals in general. Let's look at the treatment modalities of phobic disorder. The behavioral therapy, this is a very important and very useful method of management of phobic disorder. Firstly, it is the systematic desensitization. So it's a long time-taking process, but it definitely has very good results. Flooding, on the other side, works differently. Although it also works as a behavioral treatment, flooding is where, for example, if there is fear of ants or fear of mice or something of that sort, the situation is created where, as the name suggests, all the provoking phobic factors are flooded towards the individual. So flooding is almost like trying to drown the individual in his phobic factors for him to rise up in spite of all that. So that's another method of psychotherapy. Then the insight-oriented psychotherapy. This is for the psychologically minded and not very severe phobic disorders. This is helpful. By insight-oriented, we mean one must help the individual go back in time or identify what exactly is the provoking stimuli, what is provoking the anxiety or what is provoking the fear in that individual, in him or her, and try to deal with that particular stress. Pharmacotherapy definitely plays a huge role in managing phobia, and the basis, as most of anxiety disorders are purely of serotonin, noradrenaline and dopamine. So the first choice of medicines are selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. Amongst them, the more commonly used SSRIs are fluoxetine and paroxetine. Fluoxetine is used in doses between 20 to 60 mg per day. The half-life of fluoxetine is between 4 to 6 days. Usually, fluoxetine is prescribed in the mornings and after a meal, because the side effects of fluoxetine are nausea and dyspepsia, very commonly encountered. So you don't want the individual to take the tablet on an empty stomach, or anyone who has who already has peptic ulcer or any other gastric disturbances, fluoxetine is preferably avoided. But it's a very good molecule if given to the rightly identified individual. Sexual dysfunction is another of side effects. Another thing with fluoxetine is, in some cases, in the initial few days of treatment with fluoxetine, there could be a rebound anxiety. The patient must be reassured that it's a brief thing and over time it will calm down. In those cases, it can be started at 10 mg and slowly increase the doses. The other more commonly used drug to treat phobia is paroxetine in the doses 20 to 60 mg. Usually paroxetine is preferably given in an extended release formulation, which are available as 12.5 mg or 25 mg or 37.5 mg. Because the half-life of it is 21 hours and you do not want to keep dosing if you want to avoid BID dosing, usually extended release drugs are given. Extended release paroxetine is the preferred choice. The half-life is 21 hours and the more common side effect of paroxetine is sedation. In some cases, extrapyramidal symptoms are also noted. Well, so one needs to be watchful at every follow-up.